Now, Access Tech Live headlines.
So, Stephen, just hours ago, Elon Musk's company SpaceX successfully launched their Starship vehicle. This is the giant one with a heavy rocket booster from their Starbase launch facility in Texas. This is the third attempt to launch this ship, which will hopefully and eventually transport people to Mars. Not only was the launch itself successful, but it made it into orbit and successfully conducted all of its tests, gathering an amazing amount of data for future launches. Now, the two prior attempts ended in intentional self-destructions roughly about 4 minutes after launch. So this is a pretty big milestone, not only for the company SpaceX, but for space travel in general. Tomorrow, March 15th, is World Sleep Day, an opportunity to promote sleep health across the world. Apple's on top of it, of course, with great sleep resources in iOS, everything from sleep tracking to sleep reminders, and even a wind down schedule you can create on Apple Watch and iPhone. Post a link to it in our social media for all of the resources. Popular Windows screen reader JAWS, created by Vispero, has launched a new AI service they're calling Picture Smart AI. The new feature allows screen reader users to describe photos using AI when all text isn't available. While Picture Smart itself isn't a new feature, the AI part is, and it's going to add a whole new level of description of images, furthering the accessibility of the service. JAWS users can actually enable that feature now by pressing Alt-O in the program window, open the options window, and then E to select early adopter program. Very, very cool. Microsoft's annual Ability Summit was last week and focused on the advancement of accessibility with AI technology and innovation. The summit highlighted the latest technology and tools for Microsoft, of course, including Copilot for Windows, which makes accessibility easier by enabling new accessibility skills in Windows. Paralympian Lex Gillette was on hand and shared his top 7 AI accessibility tools at Microsoft, including Seeing AI, of course, which was designed to help visually impaired people better understand their surroundings. Finally, Stephen, Airbnb is putting guest security first and banning the use of any and all indoor security cameras in owners' homes. Now, the use of indoor cameras have always been allowed and a contentious issue in common areas like living rooms and hallways. And the new ban is going to take effect April 30th and restricts them anywhere throughout the entire home. After this date, reported violations will result in penalties. Big move on Airbnb's part, but definitely something that a lot of people, especially users, Stephen, of those homes have been complaining about, which leads us perfectly into our question of the day, doesn't it?
It does. And I want to just quickly just stop you there because
World Sleep Day.
Right, okay, I'm sleeping in tomorrow. That is it. I am sleeping in because officially it's allowed. Every tech company demands it of me.
Is it allowed, though? I don't know if it's actually allowed or not. We're going to have to check the fine print on the rules. But yeah, no, World Sleep Day tomorrow. Listen, sleep is important. It's an important. Second to breakfast is probably the most important part of the day, right?
Absolutely. I did, and I have recently just set up that sleep schedule on my iPhone. And I love that every night, about 10:30 or even 10 o'clock, I get this little chime that goes, doo-doo-doo, and then that's it. And then it tells me it's going into sleep mode. And I love it. And that means I know it's time for bed. Even the dog now knows it's time for
bed.
It gets up as if to say, oh, right, okay, time for bed now. Okay, let's go. And that's it. The night is over. You're just settling down to watch a good film, and the dog's decided it's time for bed, which means, of course, it's time for bed. But no, you're absolutely right. Security cameras in the home, it's a contentious issue. I've got to say, it is a different thing with Airbnb, I think. I go with this. I don't think there should be an Airbnb homes. I think that, you know, we've all seen the horror movies. We don't want that happening in real life. So, you know, I think, this is maybe a good thing on the part of these companies to perhaps move away from having these in the home. But you're right. It does lead us into a rather interesting question that we're putting to you this week, which is, what is the strangest thing you've captured on your home security cameras?
Could be strange, could be funny. I mean, I've got some great funny stories that I'll save for the end of the show that probably will get me in trouble, but we won't get into details of that. So the question is, what is the strangest thing you've captured on your home security cameras? I don't know. Maybe it's a cat eating something. I don't know. A squirrel trying. Who knows? We'll figure it out. Let us know. You can connect with us on all our social media platforms, which are at Access Tech Live. You can also email it to us if you want feedback at accesstechlive.com so you can get involved. You know what? Send us a video if you've got one. That'll be a lot of fun. That'll be fun for the email. Feedback at accesstechlive.com. What is the strangest thing you've caught on those cameras? Stephen, it's the world's largest event dedicated to exploring new ways technology can assist people with disabilities, often referred to as the CSUN conference. And we've got their interest Harvard Managing Director, up next to preview what's coming up at next week's event. Stick around. This is Access Tech Live.
There's more Access Tech Live to come. Get involved and have your say at Access Tech Live on social media. We'll be right back.